I mean, I guess I can keep playing these games for the next year while you wait for the next big game. Come on, man. I'm recording this video literally on day three of E3. It's currently Tuesday, so if you're watching this, it should be Wednesday, but I'm recording this literally at the end of all the conferences. Now, for the record, the Bandai conference is gonna actually happen in 2 hours, but based on what we saw that was already announced on Twitter, it's gonna cover a completely different game, and we're not gonna get announcements over there. If for some reason we do, this video's gonna be redone. But for right now, No Dragon Ball game announcement this year. That's kind of weird. Before I hop into it, this is like the most infamous question you get whenever you discuss new Dragon Ball games.
Don't they have to follow the rules, the contracts, and drop an annual game?
No, that's an old thing. You know, we had that point in time where they would drop an annual Dragon Ball game because they kind of have to like stick to the licenses. And I'll be honest with you, I don't really know how licensing works at the end of the day. I just know you license it, you make the money, you make the games and all that stuff. But over the course of time, since Bandai has been basically monopolizing anime games, they kind of, I guess, got more loose with how they can and can't do certain things. You know, in this case, they're not supposed to drop an annual game anymore. They don't have to do that. On top of that, Dragon Ball Super ended. It's coming back in the format of a movie, but for right now, it's been kind of quiet and dead. When that movie comes back, I'm sure they're going to have, you know, a lot of content coming out around that in regards to probably new games, merchandise, yada, yada, yada. But usually, as I mentioned, you know, previously in the past, whatever a series is kind of like on hold in regards to have like an anime that's going on, it's a bit more difficult to put out games and content around that, if that makes sense. I know it sounds kind of weird, because, you know, we had that period in time where Dragon Ball Z had ended, and we didn't even have Dragon Ball Super, and they were still putting out games. It's, again, it's very complicated, and over the course of the past, like, 10 years, the licensing stuff all evolved, and basically, right now, we're to the point where they don't have to drop an annual game anymore. So, yeah, here we are, with no game. I mean, I guess, technically, we got a Dragon Ball announcement this year. You know, they announced that Kakarot was coming to the Switch, or is coming to the Switch later this year. And by the way, this doesn't count as their Dragon Ball release for the year. You know, I think in the past we've seen games get localized or put out on other platforms that people always assume, like, does that mean no game? That's not how this works. And something else I want to point out is the year is not finished yet. You know, you still got the Tokyo Game Show, you got Junk Festa, you got a lot of stuff happening this year where they could potentially announce a new game. But as I mentioned last week, I just don't think it was likely for them to drop a Dragon Ball announcement at E3. On top of that, once that Microsoft showcase ended, I was just like, wow. We didn't even get the Demon Slayer announcement yet. And to be fair, Demon Slayer is being done by Aniplex, and I believe Sega in the rest of the world, which is not Bandai. I don't know how Aniplex managed to get the license for Demon Slayer instead of Bandai, but they did. So in regards to the reveal of Demon Slayer's official English announcement, they're probably gonna save that for the end of the month whenever they do the Sony conference, which is not part of E3. Sony's gonna be doing their own thing at some point, I believe either the end of the month or early July, but in the next couple weeks. Just, I guess, when we get to that point, we'll talk about it then. But for now, no Dragon Ball game! How much longer can I play Xenoverse 2? This is Xenoverse 1. I don't have a physical copy of Xenoverse 2. And how much longer can we play Fighters? I mean, honestly, if you keep dropping content, I can play these games forever, you know? You announce a Season 4 for this, I'm going to be a happy, happy Dragon Ball fan. Like, literally, just even announcing patches and stuff like that is going to breathe a lot of life into these games. Comment section below, by the way, if you do play Fighters, I know it's not for everybody because not everybody likes fighting games. If you do play Fighters and they do a Season 4, who would you personally lead Season 4 with? Let's do two characters. Let's say Season 4 gets announced and they drop two characters. Who are you choosing and why? Let me know down below. As far as Xenoverse, again, I have always had mixed feelings about Xenoverse. I love the Xenoverse series. I think what they did for Dragon Ball gaming franchise in general was fantastic. And I love the fact that they're still dropping content for it. I mean, think about it. This game came out in 2015 and 2016 for the sequel, and they're still dropping DLC. That to me is so cool because it's like, they know there's a big, big fan base for the game. And I know there's gonna be that one person in the comments is gonna be like, you still play Xenoverse and blah, 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 dead game. Yes, there's a lot of people that still play this game. This game actually, surprisingly, is still printing money. The game is still printing money in regards to, you know, people buying DLC content. It's got hella players still. Surprise, surprise, a lot of people still play this. And on top of that, with them dropping more content, I don't see that as a bad thing. You know, if you're not gonna be doing a sequel, if you're not gonna be doing Xenoverse 3, which we still don't know what's happening with that, I'd much rather be getting content still through the form of like DLC, because I don't mind that. On top of that, involving the fans by letting us vote for like the next DLC character for Legendary Pack 2, I think it's very, very dope. As far as what's going to happen beyond that, I have no idea. But at this point, the meme is Xenoverse is going on until 2069. That's how long this game's been happening. But that said, though, what does this mean for the next game? I honestly don't know. You know, as I mentioned, Tokyo Game Show is happening, what, in a couple of months? You still got Jump Festa at the end of the year. There's still room for them to announce the next big game. And honestly, with how it's been going, I feel like the next game is going to be something completely different, which I'm okay with, you know? It's risky, because if it ends up being something different, there's always that chance where it could just be hot ass. And the last thing we want is we have waited this long for the next game to be hot ass. It's like, please, just make it at least playable and enjoyable. And then after that, wherever they decide to go with it, it's all up in the air. One thing that I always loved about Dragon Ball, and I say this all the time, which is why I picked Dragon Ball as like my main content on YouTube, is every time I get a game, it's always something different. I mean, just look at the variety here. You got your 3D Arena Fighter where you can be yourself. You can be in this game. It's got a ton of content. It's got an original story, kind of original story, but original story. The concept of Xenoverse is very, very dope to me. If you ever take Xenoverse and you fix the issues, like let's say they do a Xenoverse 3 or even a sequel, like a spiritual successor to Xenoverse, and you make it so the netcode actually works properly, at least somewhat. You know, you'll never have perfect netcode, but let's say you make it at least usable and playable. This series is going to be the greatest Dragon Ball series of all time. The problem with Xenoverse right now, and if you want to contribute to your own opinion down below, is you got the netcode is hot ass. You know, you can get a situation where it's so desynced where you'll punch the air, you'll get the hit marker, and you'll be confused, like, how do I get a hit marker? And because in their end, you did hit them. But because it's so desynced so badly, false hit confirms ruined the game. On top of that, balancing is weird. You get your stamina broken one time, you just explode. You can take the Xenoverse series and just perfect it to just an art form. And the thing is, even right now, it's so fun. That's why so many people play it. Talking about the variety of games. We got Kakarot. You know, again, there's a lot of mixed feedback in regards to Kakarot. I personally like it. It's an RPG game. It's super bonus, but it's an RPG game. The fact that we have a RPG game, you know, we got our fighting game, we got our RPG game, is dope to me. And then we get Fighters, which is an actual fighting game using Dragon Ball skins. Marvel vs. Capcom meets Dragon Ball. Like, that kind of, like, range of games in the Dragon Ball realm is dope to me. Let alone, also don't forget the different mobile games we got. We also got all the different handheld games like Dragon Ball Fusion. This is basically a Dragon Ball game for every fan out there. In fact, in the comment section below, what is your personal favorite Dragon Ball game of all time and why? I'm just going to toss out there again. Let me know down below. Because again, I guarantee you everyone's answer is going to be different. For the most part, you're going to get a lot of crossovers. You get a lot of people who are going to say that they love the Xenoverse series. You're going to get a lot of people that love Fighters. You're going to get a lot of people that love the mobile games. Like, there's a game for everybody. And that's something I love about the Dragon Ball community for games. But yeah, so it's like, still though, it's weird going into E3 with no big anime announcement. You know, over the last couple of years, we always had a big anime game get announced through Microsoft. You know, we had Kakarot announced there. They dropped the news of Fighters happening there. They mentioned Jump Force as well. But regardless, every single time a Microsoft conference went up at E3, they always had some kind of game to announce, which absolutely hyped us all up. No matter how bad the game might have turned out over time, it was still hyped to see. And going into E3 this year and not having that, I was just kind of like, okay, all right then. You know, I guess I'll keep playing these for now. Man, on top of that, we also had like that leak that mentioned we're going to get My Hero Fighters, and it sounded so real, so accurate. There's so many details, and again, I gotta mention that when you go online and you read things like this, a lot of times you don't know who's posting this information. And the problem is this one person posted, then another person posted, then everybody's talking about it, then you have to talk about it as well, only to get disappointed at the end of the day. That's why a lot of times I see and read stuff online, I'm like, you know what, I'm gonna just wait to see what happens, because I don't believe anything. Now, I do want to also mention that we do have the PlayStation conference happening. It should be the end of the month. And honestly, I'm willing to bet that Demon Slayer will be shown off there, because in Japan, they have more of a focus on PlayStation. I don't think Xbox is even really a thing over there. I think you can buy one, but it's not like a big popular thing just because Japan prefers PlayStation over everything. And with Bandai not doing Demon Slayer, which means Bandai, who usually gives all their announcements to Microsoft, I'm sure Aniplex and Sega's doing it for the rest of the world, are going to announce and reveal actual Demon Slayer stuff for the rest of the world when that happens. So for now, it's just kind of like up in the air. But again, I feel like it's weird having an E3 without an anime announcement, without a Dragon Ball announcement at that, and we just kind of keep waiting. So yeah, give me your best prediction. Tokyo Game Show, TGS, Jump Festa, Gamescom, what do you guys think we're going to get in any of these as far as, you know, the next game? You know, I still see all the time a lot of people are expecting a Xenoverse 3 to be announced. A lot of people are expecting, some people still expecting Raging Blast 3 to happen, which is just very, very unlikely, but they're still expecting it. I even see people talking about like a Burst Limit 2. I think it's time that, you know, they really explore the next potential realm in Dragon Ball games and give us something cool, refreshing, and different. Again, it's risky because the game could be hot ass, but it's still, if you get it right, it's gonna be a lot of fun. You know, I mean, look at this. We went from the Xenoverse series to fighters to an RPG. I feel like with how they've been going, the pattern, all we got left now is the next game. Whether it be, this is very, very unlikely, but imagine they drop a Dragon Ball Battle Royale. I don't even know how that would work. It just sounds terrifying because team battles in Xenoverse just don't work. But you never know. Maybe they can drop Dragon Ball Kart. Super Dragon Ball Kart, you know, do like a Mario knockoff. I have no idea. At this point, they can literally do anything. And because there's such a big variety of games in the Dragon Ball world, it could work for some people, it won't work for others. You know, whatever they end up announcing, whether it be in the next couple of months or potentially even next year, maybe we won't get an announcement until E3 of 2022. Whatever they end up doing, I feel like it's going to make a lot of people happy. It's going to make a lot of people angry. But end of the day, it's going to be dope for the overall Dragon Ball sphere. Because again, these games always evolve the community. And it's, again, to me, it's just always dope that we always get something different as opposed to getting the same game. Anyway, so I'm going to end the video right here. Again, if for some reason Bandai ends up having a announcement at their stream, which I don't think is going to happen, I'll make another video and completely scrap this. You're never going to even see me. Or I might even just use this and mix it with what they actually show off at the Bandai showcase. But let me know your thoughts down below, anything we discuss. And I guess stay tuned for more as we go into the next year of questionable Dragon Ball content. I mean, honestly, I feel like, here's my biggest prediction. Until they reveal this movie, probably at Jump Festa is when they're gonna probably show it off like they did with the Broly movie. Until they actually reveal what's happening with that, I feel like Dragon Ball merch, which includes also games, is going to be very, very questionable. And once that's actually out there, once the actual movie comes back, and the anime comes back as well, there's going to be more that they can do around those. But for now, because the anime ended in 2018, it's like, they don't really know what they can't do, what they want to do. It's just kind of like, you're just threading water at that point. So until those series come back, until the anime returns, this is basically what we're going to be getting with Dragon Ball for the next year or two, if that makes sense. So yeah. For the love of God, show us the movie already. With that said, let me know your thoughts down below on everything we discussed. And let me know your favorite kind of Dragon Ball game. And I guess I'll see you guys in tomorrow's video, and also the comment section below. But yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.